And welcome again, dear friends, to the Friday edition of Fresh Bread. Well, here it is now, Friday, February 25th, 2022, just a few days left in the month of February. Hey, I hope it's been a good month for you. Hope 2022 is off to a good start for you. Feels like we're still in the middle of a new year, but my goodness, March is just around the corner. And once March gets here, it feels like spring can't be too far behind. And so actually, we are really right on through this year. Amen. I pray that things are going well for you. And today, again, we're just going to look at the lectionary reading for today found in our book of Deuteronomy. You know, as we said yesterday, it's always all about the Lord. It's always all about God. And we have to always ascribe everything to Him. We have to honor Him with everything. It's not about what we've done. It's not about what we bring to the table. It's about what God has done. And that we trust in Him and He brings us along. He leads us where He wants us to go. But we always give Him the credit. We always give Him the honor, always give Him the glory, because it's not about us. It's about Him. And just depend totally on Him. Let Him just caress us and embrace us and let us know that with Him, all things are going to work out just fine. We just have so much to be grateful for with the Lord. And so today, we're going to read a little bit of a continuation from where we started yesterday in the book of Deuteronomy. This will be Deuteronomy chapter 9 today, verses 6 to 14. Understand then that it is not because of your righteousness that the Lord your God is giving you this good land to possess, for you are a stiff-necked people. Remember this and never forget how you provoked the Lord your God to anger in the desert. From the day you left Egypt until you arrived here, you have been rebellious against the Lord. At Horeb, you aroused the Lord's wrath so that He was angry enough to destroy you. When I went up on the mountain to receive the tablets of stone, the tablets of the covenant that the Lord had made with you, I stayed on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights. I ate no bread and drank no water. The Lord gave me two stone tablets inscribed by the finger of God. On them were the commandments the Lord proclaimed to you on the mountain out of the fire on the day of the assembly. At the end of the 40 days and 40 nights, the Lord gave me two stone tablets. The tablets were of the covenant. Then the Lord told me, go down from here at once, because your people whom you brought up out of Egypt have become corrupt. They have turned away quickly from what I commanded them and have made a cast idol for themselves. The Lord said to me, I have seen this people, and they are a stiff-necked people indeed. Let me alone so that I may destroy them and blot out their name from under heaven, and I will make you into a nation stronger and more numerous than they. You know, there's a scripture passage that says that God will not share His glory with another. It goes back to what we were just saying. We give God all the credit. We give God all the glory. We give God all the honor. I remember the song, to God be the glory, great things He has done. To God be the glory, not to you or me be the glory, but to God be the glory. It's always, always all about what God has done for us through Jesus Christ. Let everything else fall away. All the trappings that the world would want to give us. Be careful of people who want to compliment you and pat you on the back. I don't resist a compliment. I think we should all compliment each other, but it needs to be sincere. And again, it should always be done with the idea that it's always ultimately about what God is doing, that He is using us, and that if we would allow Him to use us, we want to encourage people to be able to keep doing that. Let's encourage each other to stay focused on Christ and to let Him lead us and guide us wherever He would have us to go. Well, friends, thank you again for being with me today on the Friday edition of Fresh Bread here. I hope to see you back tomorrow for the weekend edition of Fresh Bread on Saturday. Until then, this is Reverend Phil Anderson, pastor of Oakland United Methodist Church and Kansas Avenue United Methodist Church here in the capital city of Topeka, Kansas. Wishing you a great Friday. May God bless you. We'll see you back tomorrow for the weekend edition of Fresh Bread.